Hello, and thank you so much for tuning into the program today. I'm your host, Neal Howard, here on Health Professional Radio. Our guest is Dr. Clemens von Schacky. He's an internationally known expert on omega-3 fatty acids, and he's joining us here on the program to discuss the omega-3 index that he co-developed, as well as some of the study findings that he contributed to as a member of the Global Nutrition and Health Alliance, or the GNHA. Welcome to Health Professional Radio, Dr. von Schacky.
Thank you.
Talk about what you feel are the key findings of the study that I just mentioned.
Well, what we did was we asked people in the U.S. and in Germany, my country, what they think about their own diet, whether it is a good diet or a not-so-good diet. Especially, we asked them about how they felt that the omega-3s would work out in their diets. And we compared the answers that we got with the omega-3 index levels, meaning that we assessed the status of these persons in terms of omega-3s.
So what was the purpose? What prompted you to conduct the study from the outset?
Well, earlier on, we had already conducted a study that showed that there is a difference between what people think, what they know, and what they do. And this shows up in terms of omega-3 fatty acids as well. Think they are having enough. They think that omega-3 fatty acids are good for them, but they don't really get access to omega-3 fatty acids.
So not having access, is that the main problem, or is it more about having access to the knowledge or awareness?
What we found in the present study was that people know a lot of omega-3s. They know that they have heart health benefits, and they also have brain function benefits, and so on and so forth. But what we measured in the bloodstream was very low levels of omega-3 fatty acids.
Okay, so folks know about the benefits of omega-3 fatty acids, but they're not showing up in their blood work. What, in your opinion, or based on the study findings, would you say is the reason that people aren't getting enough of these omega-3 fatty acids?
Well, I think it's a two-step thing. One is that they sort of don't think that they have to be, so to say, they have to take one step at a time. Mm-hmm. One thing is to realize that you're not getting enough. The next step is to do something about it. And I think they are somewhere in between right now. They are starting to realize that they might not have enough, but they haven't really done anything about it yet.
Is diet alone enough? Is it just enough to improve your diet and include an abundance or at least the recommended amount of these omega-3 fatty acids, or is there still more to be done?
I wish I knew. The thing is that omega-3s are sort of disappearing from our diet. It's not just that the sources are disappearing, foodstuff that we used to eat and we no longer eat, like kettle brain, for instance, for good reasons. It's also disappearing because fish farming is using less and less omega-3 fatty acids. So the diet, by and in itself, might even be good, and yet people don't get enough omega-3 fatty acids.
Would you say that people who live closer to abundant sources of, aquatic life, whether by in the sea or fresh water, would you say that they have an abundance of these fatty acids in their diet as opposed to people who are living away from these water sources? Or does it matter? Is it just a matter of people getting these acids regardless?
It's both, as usual. The thing is that we do see a sort of a gradient in Germany. People living closer to the coast have higher levels. But then there's also very high levels far away from the coast in certain individuals. And these high levels do not necessarily come from the diet. We always see some individuals that just have high levels. I cannot explain that to you because they don't eat that much the omega-3 fatty acids. They just have high levels. And we also see some individuals that eat a lot of omega-3s and still have low levels. So diet isn't the only thing that impacts on the levels. It's other factors as well.
So what do these factors mean for the average person who's looking to improve their intake of omega-3 fatty acids?
Well, I might be biased here, but I think that having your levels measured is a good first step, and then you know where you're at.
Just simply having them measured, is this something that's invasive? Is this something as simple as a pinprick, say for like diabetes testing, or is it something that has to be determined through your healthcare provider?
It can be determined through your healthcare provider in Germany. It's part of the insurance package that you get from a private health insurance. It's not part of the health insurance in the U.S., and then you would have to pay that yourself.
So overall, for the healthcare community, when trying to educate the population as well as treat the population for this lack, this deficiency of these very important omega-3 fatty acids, what does that mean for you as a healthcare provider and the healthcare community at large?
Well, for me as a healthcare provider, it means that I should be measuring levels in all of my patients, and the patients that I'm taking care of, and my colleagues do that as well. Of course, there are certain populations that are more at risk than others, and that's true, for instance, for athletes. But then on the other hand, as we also saw in our present study, more than 90% have levels below the optimal range. So it's a huge proportion of the population in Western countries. This is not the case in, for instance, Japan or in South Korea. In these two countries, we see more than 80% of the population within the optimal range. So it's easily feasible, but it's not being done in Western countries.
Now, as we wrap up, Doctor, talk about some of the health issues associated with the diminished intake of omega-3 fatty acids, or theoretically, the total disappearance of these acids.
Well, from what we see in our data, it's that people who have low levels tend to die earlier. They tend to get demented earlier. For instance, we have done a study in the outskirts of Munich, here in the Augsburg area. And there we saw in octogenarians, people around 85 years old, that at that age, you basically have three options. Either you're dead, you're demented, or you have an omega-3 index of above 8. And that tells me something. And my personal plan is to get old and not be demented at old age.
And omega-3 fatty acids are a big part of that plan.
Yeah, that's a part of that plan, and other stuff as well. But omega-3 fatty acids are a major player when it comes to getting older and when it comes to brain function.
Where can we go and get some more information about the types of supplements that we should be taking and about improving our diet to include more omega-3 fatty acids, Doctor?
Well, there's all sorts of sources of information on the Internet, of course. And one good source would be the website of the Global Nutrition and Health Alliance.
Well, I appreciate your time and thank you for this valuable information. Dr. Clemens von Schacky, internationally known expert on omega-3 fatty acids. Thank you for coming in, and I'm hoping you'll come back and join us again.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neal Howard. Transcripts and audio of the program are available at healthprofessionalradio.com.au and also at hpr.fm. You can subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, listen in, and download at SoundCloud. And be sure and visit our affiliates page when you visit us at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au.